Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everybody's doing well and having a great day. In this video, we're going up to the International Space Station. I'm going to share with you guys a video that I found today of a huge swarm of lights in the vicinity of the International Space Station going back to July 6th. I shared a photo about 4 days ago of what looked like a small fleet of objects in the vicinity of the International Space Station on the daytime side of the Earth. And someone had left a comment that maybe these were pixel anomalies, some sort of an issue with the pixels in the image. And I was like, you know what? That's a good question. So I went back and looked, and I found even more lights on the nighttime side of the Earth. And I'm talking a huge swarm that we're going to come back and look at here in just a moment. So I don't think those were pixels. Coming over here to VentureSky.com, looking at the temperatures out here in the southwestern United States, we might see an all-time new record high today if this temperature verifies. Over here at VentureSky, showing 135 degrees at 4 p.m. today in Death Valley, California. The current record is 134 degrees, and that would be the all-time record high for planet Earth. That could be challenged today if that temperature verifies at 4 p.m. this afternoon. I know this is fairly accurate. I use VentureSky all the time. Where we live over here in the Phoenix area, this is accurate. It's 109 degrees exactly where we live. So I know this is normally a good source of information, and they're showing the all-time record high temperature for planet Earth could be challenged today over in Death Valley, California. Speaking of California, remember the 6.0 magnitude earthquake that occurred on July 8th? I had two people share with me that they felt the earthquake. Polenta, who lives up in the Northern California area, said she felt the earthquake. I also had a video sent in by Roland, who felt the earthquake, and I want to share that video with you as he and his family ran out of the house as the earthquake was occurring. And here's the video that Roland shared with me from Arnold, California, which is just east of Stockton, California. Here's the video that Roland shared with me of that earthquake.
Big one. That is a big one.
Oh my God.
Well, you don't even see it in the trees. It's still going.
I can feel it.
Yeah, I can feel it too. Power lines aren't shaking. But yeah, a little bit.
He says that's the biggest one he's ever felt. He and his family ran outside of the house as the 6.0 magnitude earthquake was occurring. Said they felt it pretty strongly for about a minute. And as you could hear in the video, this overhang up here was squeaking very, very rapidly as the ground was shaking very quickly, but the trees weren't swaying at the time he and his family ran out of the house onto the back porch. But they felt the earthquake. Polenta felt the earthquake, and I know a lot of other people felt the earthquake in California, so I wanted to share that update with you guys. And there have been dozens, if not hundreds, of aftershocks in that location where the 6.0 magnitude earthquake occurred. It was a 6.2, then downgraded to a 5.9, and now recently back upgraded to a 6.0. I want to take you guys now up to the International Space Station. Again, I posted this photo about 4 days ago of what looked like 10 or 11 dark objects in the field of view from the live cam of the International Space Station. Jeff was watching the International Space Station on this day, noticed these objects come into the field of view, and just started taking screen grabs. Shared them with me, and then I went back and did some more research, and I found an even bigger swarm on the nighttime side of the Earth on July 6th of 2021. Here we go. I go over here and check this out all the time too, but right there goes the first one. But it's not every day you see a swarm like this. In fact, I've never seen a swarm like this. Don't know what these are. There's no meteor showers ongoing. There have been no meteors, as I'm going to show you guys here in a minute. There have been no large meteors of any kind reported down here on Earth for several days. These bright lights are going in all different directions. They're going at all kinds of different speeds. They have various degrees of brightness. I think that depends on how far away they are from this camera. You're going to see a bright flash down here in the lower right-hand portion right there of this video. I have no idea what that was, but it showed up in the bottom of the field of view. Watch these lights. They come from the left, from the right, from the top, from the bottom, from all different angles, different speeds. Some of them look like they're almost going to collide. There's dozens, probably hundreds, because this is just one field of view, one perspective. We're not even considering the rest of the field of view around the space station. This is just looking in one direction towards the Earth, mind you. Earth is down here. And July 6th, there were no reports of fireballs anywhere on Earth. I'm not saying that none occurred, because they do occur every single day. But over at the American Meteor Society, see that one there was kind of weird. Look at it. Two of them look like they're flickering. There were no reports of any type of fireballs. So if we went through a debris field of meteors, there would have surely been all kinds of reports down on Earth of fireballs entering the atmosphere. And there were none. So I don't know what this is. This is a fleet of something in the proximity of the International Space Station. This is the original video. This is unedited. This is the regular speed. I've done nothing to this but share it with you guys. There goes one there. It just kind of leaped up from the left and went straight vertical. Here comes a couple coming straight down. I have not edited this in any way. It's the same brightness as it appeared in the field of view. Here comes two bright ones here. Then you're going to see one larger, slow-moving one coming from upper left to lower right. Mary Hall sent me a video a few days ago of one coming from the lower right to the upper left. Almost looks like the same exact object. But this here is a first for me. I've seen different lights on here from time to time, maybe one, maybe two, three or four tops. I've never seen this many at one time without it being some sort of an obvious meteor shower. They spark off of the lens of this camera. I've seen those before. So I don't know where these things came from, don't know where they're going. But here they kind of slow down a little bit, and you're going to see a large one, or at least larger, come down very, very slowly from top to bottom. And then I'm going to zoom in on it, and I'm going to show you a video that Mary Hall shared with me. Mary visits this camera all the time, and she noticed an object that was almost identical to what you're about to see here in just a second. Here it comes right now. See it up here in the upper left-hand corner, moving very slowly. The other lights that you've seen on here were all moving very, very fast. And then this one here comes out of nowhere, moving super slow. It's a solid white. Some of the lights that we saw had some color. Some were blinking. This one is not blinking. It's probably the slowest of all the lights we've seen so far. And I've got a video of that same type of light going in the opposite direction you're going to see here in just a moment. But this is kind of unprecedented footage. I mean, to see something like this in the field of view of the International Space Station is kind of rare. Here I zoom in on that same exact object. But if those were any types of meteors, those could damage the space station. Here's another one sent in by Mary Hall going the exact opposite direction. See it right there? It's almost the same exact size. But this one here looks like it's tumbling. Pretty obvious that's some sort of a craft in the sky. Looks very similar to what we just saw in the first part of the video. Here in this last part of the video, what I've done is taken the original footage that I shared with you at the beginning of the video, and I put it in fast forward for an entirely different perspective. I did enhance the lighting a little bit, and you'll be able to see even more of these objects. That's all I've done is put it in fast forward and brightened it up. And see how many there are? They are literally everywhere, going in all different directions. Some appear to be traveling together, like those two there. Some come from the top, some from the bottom, from the sides, all directions, and all variations of speed. Very cool. Like I said, I've never seen anything quite like this on the space station, at least to this magnitude. There are a lot of random lights in the field of view of this camera that's on board the International Space Station. And again, meteors, any type of debris in space, can be harmful to the space station. I do know they take precautions against meteors and even little meteorites. And if that's what those were, those could have very easily damaged the International Space Station. I'm not saying they were meteors. I have no idea what those are. All we know for sure is there were several hundred lights in the field of view of the camera on the nighttime side of the Earth from the International Space Station on July 6th of 2021. So once again, we're getting close to possibly seeing a new record high from Death Valley, California. Could see at least 134 today, quite possibly 135 degrees. Coming over here to the website, quick look at the Schumann resonance. You can see there was a large spike in the Schumann in the last 24 hours. Right now, origins unknown. Hopping over to the Yellowstone supervolcano caldera, looking at the seismographs that monitor the mighty supervolcano, littered with earthquake activity. More than likely, that is residue from all of these aftershocks down here in North Central California. That would be my guess. There have been hundreds of aftershocks, some of them in the 5 range, upper 4s, and most of these are on the western side of the supervolcano caldera. That puts these just a little bit closer to the ongoing swarm right now in Northern California. See some magma intrusion on most, if not all, of the seismographs, and we currently have activity back at Old Faithful. More than likely, that was a mechanical glitch. There for days, we didn't have any activity at Old Faithful. Looking at the Earth-facing side of the sun, northeastern limb, we've got a large sunspot turning towards the Earth. It's a little difficult to tell. Looking at it from this angle makes it look bigger. It may not be as big as it looks right now, but either way, that active region and sunspot is turning towards the Earth. We'll have a much better look at that here in 24 hours. And there's also an active region down here in the southeastern limb of the sun that's starting to gain some momentum. But right now, no major solar activity. I wanted to show you guys over here at the American Meteor Society. There have been no reports since July 3rd of any significant meteor activity. Not that they get every single meteor reported here that occurs on Earth. They don't. But they do get a lot of reports here at the American Meteor Society. Right now, we're not in any meteor showers, and there have been no reports, again, since July 3rd. So if what we saw here was some sort of a meteor swarm above planet Earth, I would think that there would have been multiple reports on Earth of various fireballs in the sky from around the world. So I'm not so sure that these were meteors. These very well may have been something else. All I know is the space station was surrounded by bright lights about 96 hours ago on July 6th of 2021. Thanks for watching. Have a super day, and be safe out there.